Hello, my lovelies. Here is an energy clearing meditation for our pets and for all animals on the planet. My guides have asked me to focus upon the animals, as they too are experiencing the ascension energies. And there's a great deal on YouTube and other platforms for humans to help them and assist them with all the changes that are going on within them. But I've been given this nudge to remind us about our pets and all of those animals all over the planet who are also feeling these changes and shifts in their energies, and to all intents and purposes not able to tell us or share with us what it is they're going through. So this dear sweet little soul is called Kamiko, which is Japanese for tortoise, because she's a tortoise shell. I call her Bunny, because she's my honey bunny. And of course she has lots of other pet names. Now this dear sweet little soul, on the 3rd of May, this year, turned 20. So she's been with me from when she was about 6 months old. And she stuck by me. We have moved 16 times in the last 11 years. And she stuck with me. So in this past year or so, she's started to show signs of age. And so I've placed the crystals around her. Not this many when we sleep, but she has three crystals around her, usually at night time, which are two rose quartz and an amethyst. And we had a little hiccup a couple of weeks ago where I thought she was checking out. So I called upon Saint Germain with his silver violet flame, Hilarion, an ascended master, and any other dudes I could think of to help her through this, to either make her well or to let her spirit be released from her body. And as you can see, she came through it. I do feel that maybe there's not much more time for us to be together in the physical. And so therefore that's part of this meditation I'd like to offer and share with you. To help her to release herself from this little furry body at the appropriate time and to return to spirit. Now, throughout history, cats have played a very large role in the life of many humans. They have been known as familiars. And it is said that they could shapeshift, they could change into other animals, disguise themselves. And in ancient Egyptian times, they were revered. No one was allowed to harm them. And when their owners died, they were mummified and placed in the tomb with the owners. And there was also a story of a huge battle that was about to happen between the Egyptians and another people. And the enemies of the Egyptians showed up on the battlefield carrying cats. And immediately the Egyptians put down their weapons and refused to fight because they did not wish to see any harm come to the cats. So if you have a pet, or you know of someone who has a pet, or pets, dogs, cats, horses, hamsters, gerbils, fish, reptiles, then this meditation is offered to assist them and you to have a clearer understanding of the energies that are affecting us all. So if you would like to sit quietly, where you will not be disturbed, where you may have your animals around you, so your cat may come and sit on your lap, and your dog may sit at your feet, and as you close your eyes and you take in some lovely deep breaths, and as you breathe out, you release all energies that no longer serve your pets. So if they have been unwell, and they are holding certain energies in their lovely bodies, by you breathing in and breathing out, you can assist them to breathe out any stuck or stagnant energies in their lovely bodies. And I call upon the healing angels. I call upon Saint Germain and the silver violet flame. I call upon Hilarion, the beautiful emerald green ray, and call upon St. Francis of Assisi, who was known as the patron saint of animals. And we call upon all those angels, ascended masters, beings of light, who are the guides and the guardians of all the animals on the planet. For not only do we humans have angels and guardians and guides, but so do our animals. We think of them as just four-legged or two-legged or winged creatures who are perhaps beneath us in the pecking order of life. But these two are souls who have chosen to incarnate as an animal to bring us comfort, to teach us lessons, mainly about unconditional love. And so I would like you to imagine that your pets around you can speak with you, can tell you how they feel about you, that they love you unconditionally, that they came into your life as you have a soul agreement with them, a soul contract with these beautiful beings. And even though these agreements and contracts may be short, still they are filled with unconditional love. And a wish to be of service to you. For many animals that we take into our homes and call our pets are truly high vibrational beings. They are healers and they absorb many negative energies that we as humans experience in our daily lives. And so when some of our beautiful pets become unwell or are showing strange behavior, it is because they have picked up on the energies that are vibrating from you. Many of our pets are awakened, ascended beings. They have abilities. They have a knowingness. They have an awareness. When you leave them for a time, they know when you are coming home. So their intuition is strong. This little lady here receives Reiki regularly from me. And sometimes no more than 10 minutes is sufficient for her, because she will get up and leave. It's like she gets too hot. Or it's enough, don't need any more, Mum, thank you. So she's feeling this energy now, because the crystals are activated, they're buzzing. When you see a cat slowly blinking, slow blinks, you can do slow blinks back at them, and that shows how much they love you. That's their way of saying I love you. So now I would like you to imagine that a ball of energy is surrounding this little cat. Beautiful golden white ball of energy. I think she can feel it. And it grows larger and larger and continues to expand, filling the whole room. And then it moves up through the ceiling, through the roof of this house, and continues rising up through the sky, up above the clouds. Up above the planet, a superb golden white sphere of light, moving up and up, out into the universe, heading on a celestial journey. And it's going to its point of origin. So in ancient stories, it is said that man was seeded from the stars, and so were the animals. It is said that cats come from the constellation of Leo. Dogs come from the constellation of Sirius, which is known as the Dog Star. And all the other planets, all the other universes, are the original homes of these beautiful beings. And so the sphere of light, golden white light, is heading towards point of origin. And it moves swiftly across the universe, knowing exactly where to go, heading towards the home planet, where a portal of light, which is shaped like a window, a rectangle of soft pink light, and this golden white ball heads straight towards it. And as it enters, it feels this amazing welcome, a loving welcome, an embrace, welcoming this beautiful energy home. And there's a feeling of joy and celebration. A feeling of knowingness. A reconnection. And so whichever place or planet your pet has found itself, reconnecting with that wonderful welcoming energy, celebrating that reconnection. Then very gently, a ball of light, a golden white sphere, leaves the point of origin, comes back through the portal, the misty pink rectangle window, and it moves back across the universe, swiftly, gently, heading back to planet Earth, and bringing with it the most exquisite rejuvenating energies, healing energies, ascension energies, awakening, awareness, understanding, feeling supported. And this golden white sphere of light is getting closer and closer to Mother Earth, to Gaia. And as it does so, a golden white grid of energy surrounds and embraces Mother Earth, and from this grid, gently, slowly, little droplets of golden white energy fall from the grid down onto planet Earth. A very gentle rain, golden white energy, softly touching the planet Earth onto the fields, onto the trees, into the crops, into the rivers and the brooks, into the lakes. Into the ocean, and as this golden white energy goes into the oceans, all of the creatures of the ocean feel this wave of healing energy. It kisses them, it embraces them, it enfolds them. Helping them to feel a reconnection with their point of origin. This energy moves all around the globe, in all of the oceans, all of the rivers, all of the streams, all of the brooks, to every creature that lives in the waters, bringing blessings. And from this golden white grid, droplets continue to fall and touch the wings of all those birds in the skies. And all those birds on the ground, filling them with joy, with healing energies, with love, with that reconnection to their point of origin. So that when they sing, their songs are full of joy, with an awareness, with that awakening energy. And the golden white grid continues to let little droplets of energy gently fall down onto the planet. Touching all those creatures of the fields. The cows, the pigs, the goats, the donkeys, the horses. All those creatures that live under the ground. The rabbits, the badgers. The stoats, and all those wild creatures, the wolves, the lions, the tigers, the elephants, the snakes, the spiders, kangaroos, every single creature on the planet is being touched by this beautiful golden white energy from their point of origin. And the golden white grid releases more droplets of healing energy and touches all those creatures that are beasts of burden, all those animals that are used by mankind that are treated badly, that are abused, that are suffering. That are caged, that are enclosed, that are manacled. And those creatures that are used for breeding and are shown no love or compassion. And those creatures that are used for experiments who are shown no love or compassion. The golden white grid contains the energy of the creator of all that is. And as these droplets of energy touch all the creatures on the planet, so is there a feeling of joy, of upliftment, of release. And among those creatures on the planet, we ask that this energy touches those in human form who have these animals in their care, but do not show them loving kindness or compassion. And we ask that this energy touches their hearts, opens them up, so that they now share compassion and loving care for those creatures and animals in their lives. And so as we come to your individual pets, whoever they may be, see the droplets of golden white energy coming down from the grid and gently blessing your pet. Your loved ones, your fur babies. And see this energy entering through the top of their heads, filling up their little heads. Or their big heads, filling their brains, clearing their eyes and their ears and their noses, their tongues and their teeth, and it moves down their throats, into their necks. Down the spine. Into the tail, if they have one. Into every little strand of hair on their bodies. Or into every feather on their bodies, or in every scale on their bodies. And this energy moves down into their paws. Into their feet, into their claws, or their hooves, or their flippers, into their whiskers, into their plumes, and then into every organ in their bodies. So into their chest, into their rib cage, heart and lungs, kidneys, bladder, large and small intestine, ovaries. Wombs, prostate, testicles, into their bones. See this golden white energy moving through their bones, through the blood vessels. Restoring, regenerating, clearing away any blockages.